You know, today I'm going to talk about Western Union payments.
Okay.
Unless you know exactly where it's going and who it's going to and you expected to do it. But just like the rest of the year, the same trends tend to be true at Christmas, but the scam artists pick it up and we have to be on the lookout for those things.
Okay, now obviously a lot of it would be coming through your email or through your devices. And before you give a dime, it probably would not be a bad idea to log on to your website and say, okay, here's what I'm thinking about donating to or doing something with. Is this legit?
That's right. I think Lynn from our office that does our charity review is here. So we have certain standards and we ask people to disclose facts. And so we have a great database of national and local charities, and you can go to it and see exactly what they measure up with. We have 20 standards, so you can see if a charity meets all 20 or 18 or 20. You can see what their CEO makes, how much they spend on overhead, how much money actually gets to programs. And if we don't have information on them or something to share, call us and we'll begin the research. But be leery of charities at this time of year that aren't people that you know. Okay. I always suggest if you can go knock on their door and see the people you want to support, those are the best charities to support.
Yeah. Go do right your here. Research, do your homework so you're staying safe.
That's
but
right.
Let's talk about some of those big scams that are going on.
Yeah,
right
so you know, over the last couple of years, we've talked to you about everything from dating service scams, Craigslist scams, lottery scams. All of those things tend to have one thing in common, and that is the victim is asked to go wire money through Western Union to a place far away.
Now, why is that the case? Why is it that one place?
Well, the way that wire transfer works, it's very hard to track. And typically, they've been very laxed in setting standards. That's why the Better Business Bureau, years ago, began sharing all of our files with the FTC. The Federal Trade Commission.
Right.
And recently the Federal Trade Commission extracted a fine from Western Union of over $580 million.
Oh my God.
And what?
It has created
half $1 billion,
yes,
more than that.
So you wonder how much money are they really making off of these kinds of scams. But that is a fine that's going into a pot where consumers that have been scammed can apply to get money back. And it's a real deal. Somebody in our office, somebody that works on these things all the time, regretfully had a relative, and they think they stand to get thousands of dollars.
Thousands?
Yeah.
Okay, so, there's the online claim site.
We
put
Seriously.
This up. So we're really, you know, oftentimes you feel like these scam artists are winning. Today we feel like the good guys are winning, and people that have been scammed have a chance to get some of their money back. And the BBB, the Better Business Bureau, is kind of proud to play a role in that. So you can contact us or go directly to that site to apply for a refund. You have to tell your story. That will add to the database of what we know and how we realize these scam artists are working. But I'll tell you, even with my own kids, you may have heard me tell the story before. My son is now 25. When he was about 18, he wanted to sell his car. And it got to be this Craigslist back and forth with this guy who was a for sure buyer. But at the last second, he needed to send us money ahead of time because he wanted all the taxes and everything to be paid. It got confusing.
Okay.
And all my son had to do was wire back a couple of $100. And he was going to get more than his asking price. And my son was so dang excited. And I kept saying, slow down, boy.
Slow down.
Slow down. Because it's always suspicious when you got to pay somebody.
Right.
The check, I let him proceed, but never wire money, only to show him that the check that they sent us was completely phony.
Right.
When we got the check, everybody would have fallen for it and said, hey, I got my $2,000 check. I just need to send this guy back $200 and... you know, we're all fine.
Really?
And that's what happens. You go into the Western Union or other wire services, in this case it's Western Union, and you wire the money thinking, well, who cares if it costs me $200? I still got more than my asking price. And that happens with dating services and lottery winnings. It happens a lot with escrow services on mortgage. You've overpaid, you know, you have to pay the taxes on the money that we're gonna send you, so please wire us the money to pay them, and then we'll send you the check for $800 or $900. It's, you know, it's rarely in the hundreds of thousands. It's in these little
increments.
Chunks
increments.
Of money.
So you don't always think it doesn't connect.
Yeah. And you think, well, I'll do that because in the end, I'm going to get $800.
Right.
Even if they're scamming me out of $200, I'm going to get $800. The fact is, you're never going to get your $800.
Right.
So we're proud to be partners with the FTC. In fact, they were in town a couple weeks ago when we hosted a small business forum.
Right.
So we partner with them a lot, but they've done good work to create this pot of money with Western Union money. And we hope your viewers that may have gotten scammed will go to it and get some of their money back.
Yeah, so don't be embarrassed. If you've been scammed, you need to collect. Try to collect the money that you lost.
I'm glad you said that because we know that most people that have been scammed in this way, as soon as they realize they're scammed, they don't tell anybody. They don't tell their wife.
Yeah, they
don't
hush
their
up
kids,
about it. Yeah.
They don't tell their friends. But this is a way that they can kind of quietly go and make things right. And the rest of the world won't know their names, but we can kind of learn their stories so that we can warn people even better in the future. So
wonderful.
We're glad we're here today sharing this story. We talk a lot about how people have gotten scammed over by bad people around the state, around the country, more likely around the world. And so we're really happy that we're here today sharing some good news. So we hope those viewers of yours log on to FTC.
Can we pull that page up again real quick here on the FTC site?
Otherwise, they can always contact the BBB.
That's right. You guys
will guide them in the right direction as
and
well.
And maybe you'll throw up our number, but you can reach us at
1-800-222-1600
or locally at 243-8137.
Well, right. Thank you for keeping us informed. Remember, if it seems too good to be true, it probably is.
It always is.
But that's some great advice this morning, Chris. Thank you so much for joining us here.
Yeah, it's always fun to be here. Thanks for all you do for Central Iowa.
Perfect.
Thank you. And let us know how many people are collecting.
We will.
And how
much
are getting back, okay?
We'll bring some stats back.
Perfect.
Wonderful.
That works. All right, 10 minutes before 8 o'clock, and we will be right back. This is CW Iowa Live.